Texas Tech sacked him 6 times last week. He's been dropped 9 times. Third down and goal to go from the 17-yard line. It is loud at Bill Snyder Family Stadium. Looks it open, coming across the middle. Pass is complete. McDougal, he is going to be well short of the end zone. Barry Meyer, the holder. High snap, Meyer brings it down. Kick is on the way, and it is no good. Daniel Thomas behind Gregory in the backfield. And he'll have his first carry. He is a big back, breaks over the right side. Still on his feet to the 40-yard line. Pickup of 20 on the play before Stuckey brought him down. We hit the 4-minute mark with quarter number one. 3 to snap. The fake to Sharp. Reesing has some time. Plenty of time. Looking deep, and it's going to be picked off. Nobody was there. Lemieux with the interception. And Reesing misses the tackle, and then he's finally knocked out of back down at the 45-yard line. A penalty fly because it was a shot to the head. I'm surprised they didn't use the Wildcat formation for this. Gregory looks over to the side with 3 to snap it. Looking right, holding on to the football, has a man down the sideline, overthrown, incomplete, intended for Brown. Yards so far in the ball game for a very high potent offense. Bill Pick, the backup quarterback, was in, and he is going to be dropped for a big loss. Back to the 23-yard line. Brody for 3 years at South Florida, where he got his degree from. Getting his master's now, and Gregory up top again, wide open to Strew. The tight end, and he's inside the 35, down to the 34-yard line. Lovick Smith on the stop. Field goal attempts, this will be a 47-yarder. And he's got the height, he's got the distance, and he's got the 3. Receiving, and he's given the Jayhawks 1st and 10 from the 17. Wide open far side, Briscoe looks for Pater. Does he get in? Yes, touchdown, Kansas. A little razzle dazzle. They give it to Banks. He's got a wall in front of him. There's the block. He just barely gets nicked. Last week versus Texas Tech, that's the fewest since last year against Kansas State. He's forced to run again. Will he take a knee? No. Loses the football. Kansas State looks like they may have it. And they do.
This actually looked like it was another designed draw. If you can look at Jake Sharp, you can see the strip right at the end. Can't make out who did it. I think it was
Hartman.
Hartman, you're exactly right. With that right arm, stripping the football.
3rd down and 14. Kansas showing blitz, and here they come on Gregory, and he's going down. Justin Thornton leading the charge, his first sack of the year. He has 1 field goal today, the junior. He has hit his last 6 field goal attempts. This one's got the distance. And it is no good. Wow. Reesing has to put everything up. 5 to snap it. And he is dancing around. Plenty of time. Looked at Sharp. Now he's in trouble. Penalty flags going down. Reesing, this may be for naught. And he takes a lot of, loses the football. And Kansas State will have it. Lemieux on the recovery.
Look for Kansas State to try to get him the football.
And Gregory looking, has a man, Brown, got it inside the 5, touchdown, Kansas State. That was the Lamar Brown scoring drive, all three pass completions to the junior out of Hazelwood, Missouri. K-State 4-0 when they lead at halftime this year. Let's take a look at that last play again.
Well, Banks is the inside receiver, and he's actually going to take coverage with him. At the end of the play, Brown is going to go outside on the corner route. Nobody is there because two defenders went with the one receiver inside, which was Banks.
And they go back to the Wildcat formation with Thomas. He just keeps the ball, tucks it, and he needs a block on the outside, and he's got it. Over the 45, looking for another block. Down to the 40-yard line. Jake Lapted finally running him down. Right, Gregory is the quarterback, looks over to the side. Ethan Valentine joined him in the backfield. He's going to keep it. He's got the first down inside the 25 down to the 23-yard line. Seven plays on this drive already, six rushes. Classic Kansas State. Here's Thomas out of the Wildcat. Shakes the first tackle. Jumps over the second, gets inside the 10 down to the 8-yard line. First and goal from the 5. Mark Brown, a touchdown reception, goes wide to the left. Here's Thomas, breaks through, that'll be 6. Daniel Thomas, his first rushing touchdown of the afternoon, his 11th rushing touchdown of the season. And K-State adds to the lead in the misery of Kansas.
On the right side.
Offensive line pointing out their assignments. Four-man rush. Reesing feels some pressure. Steps back. Now steps up and then gets hit from behind. Back at the 28-yard line. That'll be a loss. Antonio Felder, his second tackle of the afternoon, his first sack. Their own 37-yard line, leading 17-7. Glad you're with us on this beautiful day in Manhattan, Kansas. Here's Daniel Thomas. What a move again! Puts the shoulder down as he gets inside the 40-yard line. And it's third down and 4 with Briscoe and Meyer wide to the left. 12th play of this drive. And here comes the blitz from the right side. Reesing is hit and it's incomplete. Was level.
Reesing got everything out of that play that he could.
This will be a 30-yard field goal attempt. Good snap, and it's not going to be a good kick. Brandstetter misses the field goal. It goes to the left.
What do we have to do to keep them out of the end zone and off the board?
Both field goals missed by Brandstetter, 30-yarders. Thomas breaks in. It's a foot race. He loses the football. It looked like a hit off his hip, but he still picks up 21 yards on the carry. Oh, my. And that's going to be the end of quarter number 3. Daniel Thomas, a new career high rushing the football, 160 yards on 17 carries. Instead of 3rd and 1, it's 3rd and 6. They're going into the closed end zone, too, where it's very loud. Reesing's got time, double pumps. Chase, pass, incomplete, intended for Meyer at the 20. Now Brandstetter has missed a couple of 30-yarders. This will be a 46-yarder. Terry Meyer, the former quarterback, is holding. This may not have enough juice. Oh, it just sneaks over. They're playing it safe. 6 men on the line of scrimmage now for Kansas. 6 to snap it. They show blitz, and here they come. Gregory steps up in the pocket. Has the first down and a couple to spare. 3rd down and 4.
You would think that Kansas State's going to have to make a play in the passing game right here.
Yeah. 4 to snap it. They'll run the option. Gregory keeps it, and he's got the first down.
And the way they're winning is just prototypical Bill Snyder football.
And they've got second down. Thomas got another first down inside the 25-yard line to the 24-yard line. And then Banks standing way back at the 40, and they're probably just going to take a knee. This one's going to be in the books. And Kansas, who was picked by many to win the Big 12 North or to at least compete with Nebraska, this will probably close the door on that dream. And they are celebrating a Kansas State sideline. And he keeps his usual demeanor. Till Snyder. And our Lee Jeans quality player of the game is Daniel Thomas. Career high, 185 yards rushing the football. 131 in the second half. Kansas State will go to 6-3 on the year, 4-2 in conference play. Kansas falls to 5-4. They have now lost 4 in a row. And Bill Snyder has now won 9 straight home games versus the Jayhawks. Here's the celebration, my friends. Mark Mangino, former assistant with Bill Snyder.
Finally, as the team leaves, listen to this crowd. What does it mean to you?
Well, they've always been special. They're special now. They were special 20 years ago.
All right, Coach, thanks very much.